There are many ways to link web pages and Gmail emails to your Todoist tags. This week, I'm going to try and show you all of them in just one episode. Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working with Todoist series. My name is Carl Pullein and this week it is all about linking web pages, Gmail, email and many other things into your Todoist tasks. Now this is a viewer's request episode. I've been getting a lot of questions about all the various ways that you can link tasks to various things, so I thought I would put it all together in just one simple episode and show you how to do it. Now before we go any further, I would just like to say if you do get any value from this episode, and I would really appreciate it if you would hit that like button below. And if you want to get all the latest tips, tricks and news on Todoist, all you have to do is subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me now take you into my Todoist and show you how to link tasks to web pages, Gmail, email and various other things. Okay, let's start off with the easiest way to get a link directly into Todoist. Now, the simplest way to do this is to get the extension if you're using Safari, or the plugin or add-on if you're using Chrome. All you have to, once you've installed it, all you need to do, you'll find that it's in the toolbar up at the top here in Safari. What I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the Todoist icon. It's going to bring up the actual URL here. Now what I'm looking for is this section here between the square brackets. Now I could leave it like this, no time to die trailer, and I'm pretty sure I would know what I'm doing, but what I like to do most of the time is to be a little bit more descriptive. So in here what I'm going to do is I'm going to write watch the no time to die trailer, and then I'm going to add the task. And so what's going to happen is when I open up my Todoist, you've got the link right here. You can just click on that and it's done. Now let's move into another way of doing this. Let's say you don't want to add the plugin, that's fine. What you can do is you can highlight the URL, you can copy that, and then you can paste it into Todoist like this. Now that's one way. Then put a space, open brackets, and then type again watch the no time to die trailer, close brackets, hit add task, and now you've got the same thing. You've got the link right here, so you can just click on that. So just to show you that works, let's go into the Spectre trailer right here, and I will just pause that so we don't get the music. And then all I have to do is click either on one of these. Let's click on this one and it will open up directly in the actual link that I want. So that's one way of doing it, which is great. So that's a couple of them. Now there's another way. What about adding a Gmail email to it? And a lot of people do ask this. Now the easiest way to do this is again to get the Todoist add-on. Now when I open up this, so I'm just about to make somebody probably embarrassed. We've got the general man has left a comment on my YouTube video, and I've got the plugin for Todoist here, so I can add this to Todoist. I hit that and now I get the quick add task. Now again, I can change this if I wish to whatever I want to call it. So I can say, let's say respond to this comment, and I can add the task and also add a date. I can add a flag. I can pretty much do anything I want here. Let's just add the task to make things very simple. As you can see, that's come in here, which means I can actually work from this directly. Or let's go back into my Todoist here and that's coming. So we need to just refresh this. So I will refresh this and sync, and that should come in. It should come in. There we go. So it's come in. And again, what I can do is now I'm using Safari as my main browser, and you'll see that you've got the email link there. So there's three ways that you can get links into Todoist very, very easily. Now, there is one more that I want to show you that people don't. Let's just say that in this task, let's go to information, and you can add a comment. Now, the thing that a lot of people forget about is when you add the link down here, you want to attach a file, you can attach or link your Google Drive. So I haven't linked to my Google Drive for a long time here, so I haven't set this up. But if you wish, you can set up your Google Drive, you can connect directly to a document you have in your Google Drive, and boom, then you can just go in and out and it will open up in your browser. Really, really quite simple. The same actually applies for Dropbox. Again, I probably haven't got logged into, yeah, I need to sign into Dropbox. But again, I don't use this feature very much because I'm an iCloud user, but that's one way that you can add links. So there's various ways that you can do it. It's entirely up to you how to do it. You can get things set up so that your Todoist is working with all your devices, all your apps that you're using. And it's a really, really simple way of making life, well, making your life easier by having direct links to what you want to do. Now, I've covered a number of cases where you can connect your Apple Notes, you can connect Evernote Notes. I've done that many times to show you how to do it, but it's just like a refresher. People have been asking me, how do you connect this stuff to my Todoist? Well, there you go. Now you know how to connect everything to your Todoist inbox. Okay, hopefully you've got a lot of value from this episode. If you have, don't forget to hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe if you want all the latest tips and tricks on Todoist. And it just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Thank you very much for watching this video. Now, have I got something special to tell you about? The Time and Life Mastery version 3 course has launched. Now, this course is transformative. It will transform your life. If you find that your life is drifting from one day to the next and that you feel that you're not actually achieving your goals, then this course is going to show you how to change that. It's going to show you how to identify what is truly important to you. It's going to show you how to find what it is you want out of life and then show you the steps that you need to take in order to get there. This course is amazing. The feedback I've got from versions 1 and version 2 have just been tremendous. It has helped so many people, and I want this opportunity to tell you that it can do the same for you. I hope you will take a look at the course, have a go, take the course, and start transforming your life today. This course will do that for you. Take a look, get yourself enrolled, and hopefully I'll see you in the course.